Actually, Rohan Theora, since last few recordings, we've been talking about this. And we said this, that there are two countries, home. There is a country, foreign. And home has more labor than capital. So home is a labor-abundant nation. Foreign has more capital than labor. So foreign is capital abundant nation. And mind you, that when you talk about relative abundance, you're talking about the ratio, L by K, K by L. You're not talking about the absolutes. So there won't be any country which will have the abundance in both, because you're talking about the ratios, right? Okay, so relative abundance is defined in terms of ratio, not quality, one thing. Then we said that there are two goods, cloth and food. We also said that cloth is labor intensive, it is using more labor than capital. And food is capital intensive. It is using more capital than labor. Right. So if you draw the PPF for the home country, if you draw the PPF for the home country is labor abundant and cloth is labor intensive. So PPF is tilted more towards the cloth axis, something like this. Something like this. While if you draw the PPF for food, then foreign, sorry, PPF for foreign. Foreign country is capital abundant and food is capital intensive. So it will be tilted more towards the food axis since it is capital intensive. Right? This is going to be the PPF for home. And this is going to be the PPF for foreign. When you want to find out the relative equilibrium relative price of food, so you will need the help of relative demand and the relative supply curves. So here it is QC by QF, that is relative supply of cloth, and here you have PC by PF. This is the relative price of cloth. Right? Okay. Who is producing more cloth between home and foreign? Home is going to produce more cloth and foreign is going to produce less cloth. So the relative supply curve of the home, right, is going to be towards, I trying to make it. Relative supply curve of home is going to be like this, right? I don't know why I'm making like this, but let's say is going to be towards the right of the foreign supply curve. Because for the given relative price of cloth, home can produce more cloth as compared to foreign. Because home is labor abundant and cloth is labor intensive technology, right? And we are assuming that the relative demand curve which they are going to face, that is same. That's an assumption that the relative demand curve which they are facing, that is same. So if they are not trading with each other, then the relative price of food in the home country is going to be here, PC by PF 1. So this is the point 1. So where the relative supply curve of home and the relative demand curve are intersecting, it is going to be here. And the relative supply and the relative price of cloth in foreign country is going to be PC by PF 3. Where the relative supply curve of the foreign and the relative demand curve of the foreign, they are intersecting. This is the situation before trade. This is the situation before trade. Now, what happens is that when both the countries, your home and foreign, they are going to trade with each other, the relative prices of cloth are going to converge towards each other. And why do we say so? Firms in both countries are profit seeking? Yes, they are. They are there to make profits. Fair enough. Look at from the point of view of the home firms about the relative price of cloth. If home firms would try to sell it to the foreign country, they will be getting the higher relative price of cloth, right? So in search of getting the higher price for cloth, home country will start selling cloth to the foreign country. Yes, that is true. There are profit-seeking firms. They are going to search for the higher prices where their products are going to get the better prices. Relative to home, foreign is providing a better price for cloth. So they would want to produce cloth for the foreign country so that they can get some higher price. Is that right? That is right. When home will start producing cloth for the foreign country, and it is going to start exporting cloth to the foreign country, the supply of cloth in the foreign country is going to increase? Yes. Supply of cloth in the foreign country is going to increase. When supply of cloth in the foreign country is going to increase, the price of cloth is going to fall. So, but always think, we're talking in terms of the relative price. The relative price of cloth is going to fall from PC by PF 3 to, it will go somewhere down, right? Home has started exporting cloth. So it is not using the entire cloth for the domestic consumption. So the supply of cloth in the home country has fallen. And the product whose supply is going to fall, what will happen to the price of that product? It will increase. So the price of cloth is going to increase in the home country. So in the foreign country, the price of cloth is going to fall. In the home country, the relative price of cloth is going to increase. And it will lie somewhere in the middle. I don't know where, but somewhere in the middle, somewhere here, where they're going to converge with each other. I hope the story is clear to you in your head. So home, which is a labor abundant country, is trying to export cloth to the foreign country, and cloth is a labor intensive good, right? So the country which is abundant in the factor, country that is abundant in a factor, exports the good which is using that factor intensively. That's right. Similarly, if you think in terms of the foreign is a capital abundant nation. It is trying to produce a capital intensive good. The relative price of food, which is a capital intensive good, is lower in foreign and it is higher in the home country. So foreign exports food, which is the capital intensive good, to the home country. The supply of food is going to increase in the home country, right? Supply of food is going to increase in the home country. So in the home country, the relative price of the food is going to fall. While when the foreign has started supplying food to the home country, the supply of food in the foreign country has fallen, and hence the relative price of the food is going to increase in the foreign. So again, they will also going to get the converging towards each other. So relative price is going to be established somewhere in between the pre-trade price. So 0.1 and 0.3, they are the pre-trade prices. And 0.2, which is the price at which they're going to converge towards each other, that is going to lie somewhere in between the pre-trade price. So after trade, the relative price of cloth in the foreign country has fallen, and the relative price of cloth in the home country has increased. Earlier, it was lower in home country. Now it is little higher. Earlier, it was higher in foreign countries. Now it is little lower, right? So you can write one line which says what is that HO theorem is saying. The country that is abundant in a factor exports the good whose production is intensive in that factor. Whose production is intensive in that factor. So this is what the statement for, you can say, HO theorem, right? This is what the statement for HO theorem looks like. You with me, right? This is what we have. Huh? Okay. Thank you, Beta.